welcome back to Ultimate Bike Guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. It means a lot. In today's video, guys, we'll be working on Dodge Journey, which is the same as Fiat Fremont. What we'll be doing today, guys, we have engine light on, we cannot give it gas, we have a specific code, stay with us, we'll be diagnosing the system. Also, guys, in addition, we have more than 200 videos on this car, so please subscribe to the channel. Our mission, guys, at the shop is to save you as much money as we can. So we've been doing so many things on that car. All the tools and parts, guys, including the scanner that we'll be using and the replacement part today, okay, will be listed in the description of the video below. This scanner, it works not only on Dodge, it works on any vehicle almost you can think of. So we're going to go ahead, okay, and connect it to the OBD connector right there. Okay, OBD connector is good. Now, what we'll do, I'm going to turn the ignition on. Okay, let me start the car first. Wow, okay, the scanner is waking up. Let me start the car and you'll see what is happening. Okay, engine light on. Blinking light there as well. I cannot give it gas. It's stuck. Okay, once in a while you see a blinking powertrain light. Okay, if I put it in drive or reverse, the car will move some, okay, but I cannot give it gas. And you can see it's idling high. So let's see, guys, what is causing that. Okay, I'm going to go ahead. Okay, turn the ignition off, turn the engine off, and we'll turn the ignition on where the lights are on, but the car is not running. So we're going to go ahead, guys, okay, and we'll connect the scanner now. Okay, let me show you, that thing is amazing, guys. It can diagnose so many cars. What it does, you can access almost every module on your vehicle, read and delete codes as well. If you go to auto detect here, it's going to automatically decode the VIN number and tells us which vehicle we have. It's going to pick on its own, okay, the vehicle that we need, year, model, engine, transmission, all that stuff. So you don't have to manually do that, even though you can manually select it. In some cases, only like 2-3% of the cases, I found out that this function is not supported, but with the updates that they constantly release, okay, I haven't experienced anything like that lately. So we'll go under diagnostics now, guys. Okay, and now I'm going to go under engine computer now. So it will be under powertrain. Okay, and ECM, engine computer right here. You can even do a whole scan on the whole system. Next we'll click read codes. Okay, read codes and check out what's happening now. Battery system voltage low. That's pending, that's fine. Just low battery, but then we have code P122, okay, P2127, 2122 and 2127. The first one says accelerator pedal position sensor, circuit low, and accelerator position sensor 2, circuit low. So we definitely, guys, have a problem with our throttle position sensor. So if I go back, okay, and click live data, under usually live data you can find, okay, the throttle position, okay, throttle position sensor, okay, you can see throttle plate position, how many percent it's open, okay, right here. I'm going to give it gas and it doesn't change. Check it out now. It just stays at 7%. So definitely, guys, there is something wrong with our throttle position sensor. So what we'll do, we're going to remove our throttle position sensor. Okay, let me show you where it is, right there. We have the video on the channel, guys, how to remove it. Okay, if you need to replace it, stay with us. We'll have it on the channel and we'll replace it and see if that fixes the problem now. So what we did, okay, we replaced our throttle position sensor. I'm going to go ahead and attempt to start the car now. Okay, engine light is still on. I want to see if I can rev it up. Okay, perfect. Now, What I'll do, I'll turn the engine off, turn the ignition on only. We're going to go ahead and read the codes one more time. Let's see what it says. Read codes. Now check out the codes. Check changed from stored from active, okay, to stored. So that's definitely a good sign. It means that the problem is not there anymore. We're going to go ahead, erase the codes. Yes, yes. And I'll go under live data. Now let me show you now the throttle. Position sensor blade. Okay, it's at 7% now. So I'm going to go ahead, start the car. Check it out now, it goes to 4. And if I give it gas. Okay, it changes, guys. So you can see it definitely changes. So that definitely fixed our problem, guys. If you have any of the two codes, probably you have a bad throttle position sensor, so which is the gas pedal. Thank you for watching, guys. Please subscribe and see you guys next time.